This week on The Wire, building boosts recovery, vacancy rates fall again, and virus anxiety eases. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest, and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now, of course, please like, comment, and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, building boosts recovery. So the construction of homes provides the second largest boost to the economy among all industries in Australia, and that comes from a report by the National Housing, Finance and Investment Corporation. The Building Jobs, How Residential Construction Drives the Economy analysis found that for every $1 million of residential building construction supports 9 jobs across the economy. The report found that each million spent in the home building industry saw 2.9 million spent across the broader economy, and with each new home, 3 jobs would be supported. Residential construction has one of the highest multiplier effects of any industry, meaning its economic activity benefits other industries through spending and job creation. The jobs impact includes construction services such as plumbing, electrical bricklaying, carpentry, and architecture. This adds further to the importance to the federal government's new $25,000 grant to people building new homes. National Housing, Finance and Investment Corporation Chief Executive Mr. Dale Bond says understanding how residential construction affects jobs and flows through to the broader economy is increasingly important given the impact of COVID-19. And of course, now for our next story, vacancy rates fall again. So the national residential vacancy rate fell from 2.6% in April to 2.5% in May, and that's coming from data from the SQM research. Adelaide and Hobart each had a vacancy rate of 1.2% in May, making them the lowest among the capital cities. The year-on-year comparison reveals Perth at 2% and Darwin at 2.3% had lower vacancy rates compared to the same time last year. Over the month, vacancies rose by 0.3% in Melbourne and 0.1% in each of Sydney and Canberra. SQM Research Managing Director Louis Christopher says vacancy rates had dropped across Brisbane, Perth, Darwin and Hobart, which had pulled the overall national rate down. These capitals had also recorded some rises in asking rents for houses, while Sydney, Melbourne and Canberra saw a drop in rental prices. Christopher says the lack of international and interstate holidaymakers, as well as the hiatus of international students, has contributed to the rise in vacancies in those major cities. Christopher says vacancy rates would likely fall further in the coming months as restrictions ease. And now guys, for our final story of the week, virus anxiety eases. So consumers are less anxious about the future as a result of the government's pandemic response, an easing of restrictions and a lower cost of living. And that comes from NAB's quarterly anxiety index. Now, overall consumer anxiety fell from 60.1 points in the first quarter to 57.3 in the second. Queensland's anxiety score fell 4 points to 55.8, making the fourth most anxious state behind Victoria, New South Wales and Western Australia. NAB's index found that despite cost of living pressures easing, it was still a major driver of the overall anxiety. Main concerns included the ability to fund retirement and government policy. However, groceries, utilities and home improvements were the three largest factors that added to cost of living in the past 3 months, while transport, entertainment and travel eased the most. NAB's survey also found an increase in the number of people cutting back their spending when compared to the previous quarter. Well guys, they're the top stories for the week. Now please remember to like, comment and share this video, and don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, that's action. Thanks a lot guys, bye for now.